this thing over here, my Skrillex kind of typography thing the other day. It's not that complicated, but I guess for a few people it could be. So I thought I'd show you how I did it. And sorry if you can hear the birds outside my window, they're kind of having a bit of a punch on them. So. Anyway, if you want to get straight into it. Okay, so what you're going to need is a nice, good looking photo. It's easy to practice on a face, I guess. You could try it on, you know, just simple things, but this is the first kind of thing that I did. And anyway, I'll probably put the link to this in the description for you so you can just try out this tutorial that I've done. Anyway, let's get straight into it. What you're going to want to do first is you're going to want to make this black and white. So shortcut for that is Command Shift U, or you can go Image Adjustments Desaturate. Then you're going to go to Image Adjustments and Posterize. What this does is kind of separates the colors, so you've got your darks and your lights and your highlights and your whatever. So go to that. Two is not enough, it's only got the dark and light. You want to have a few steps in there, so yeah, I'll probably do three for this photo. Just depending on what photo you've got, just play around with it. And yeah, okay. Now to actually get the text to work easily with this, what I did was just hide that layer for now. So just gonna think of a few random words. I'm gonna do, you know, what should I do? Make it black. Use a font. Lot. That's what I used in the other one. Gonna use, why not? Just for tag, AG tag. Oh girl. Oh girl. Anyway, make it bigger. You're gonna have, you know, 3 to 4 different words. I like to do however many you want really, but I just duplicated that, make it easier. I'll do that. Okay, so shit, I'm very bad at typing. Making a bunch of bull crap here, so don't worry about that. What else can I use? It's airstrip 4, in case you're wondering. If you need to know any of the fonts or anything, just ask in the comments. Wild, because you know, usually see a mix of styles. Maybe not, maybe just go this. That's Kremlin. Okay, so what you want to do is rasterize all three of these. So select all three, right click, and rasterize type. Okay, now go to your marquee tool, shortcut M, or you can click on it. Then what you want to do is select the first word, first line, and right click and layer via copy. Wait, no, sorry about that, that was the wrong thing. You want to go to edit, define brush preset. Yep, define brush preset. Name this, there we go. What I was thinking a minute ago, that was a bit stupid. You can do this for every letter, every line, sorry. So edit, define brush preset, yeah. And last one, Okay, now, so you got that. Now, another thing we have to do before we hide these away is, I'll just make a copy of these, so I've still got the big ones. Okay, now, hide your other ones for now, and make these smaller, because this is going to be used as a pattern, so it needs to be a bit smaller, just for like filling in your space. And now you gotta go to select all of it and then edit, define pattern, just find not brush, and call this all text, whatever. Then we can group all these and hide them away. Now we bring back our face. Okay, now here's the bit where, you know, this posterized stuff comes into it. What you want to do is make a new layer, click back on your face layer, and then you can either select a little bit of your color that you want to, you got to just select each color and do it in different bits. So, you know, if you want to do the white first, select that, and then you can go select similar, and what that would do is select all the white bits, or all the bits that are exact same color as that. Or you can go to select color range, and then just click on your white, or click on your gray, or whatever, and as you can see, it selects that for you. That's okay, and then you've got your marching ants, whatever you call them. Then, go back to this layer, go to our brush, and probably have to make it black. Well, actually, no, for this, we'll make it white. Make it white. And then, just for this, I'm gonna make the background a random color so we can see everything. Okay, so that's so we can see everything. You don't have to do that. Go to this layer. Select color range. White. Okay. Okay. Now go to our brush shortcut B. We can click over here. And the brushes that we made should be down here. As you can see, there's the Skrillex ones that I did the other day. I'm gonna go to O-Girl, and here we go, here's this. If you didn't know, shortcut for changing the size like this is the next to P on your keyboard, you have your brackets. Each one goes down or up. Makes it so much easier while you're doing this kind of thing. So what you want to do is just randomly, you know, wherever you want to put it, place your brush wherever you want to put it. At the moment we're not going to see much, so you know, hide that layer so you can see what you're doing. You know, put O-Girl up at the forehead. Then, you know, just play around, put bits and pieces everywhere, really. Just copy all this. This is basically what you have to do for every colour, but there's a few things I have to show you before that. You want to kind of try and fill up most of the stuff, so like that. I think that looks pretty good. Cool. Okay, now, what we've got so far is that. Now I'll go back to this one, and then we can make another layer. Wait, so you go back to that. So you selected the white still. What you want to do is make another new layer. This is going to be for our pattern. So you go right click and fill, go to pattern and select, should be down the bottom, that one. Okay, there you go, you got all this stuff. You're going to put that behind your main text layer, and then you can probably make that white. So to do that, the easiest way to do that I find is just Command I invert, makes it white. Now as you can see, what that's done is it's kind of made everything hard to read. So this is one thing that people get wrong when they're doing this kind of thing. they make it too complicated. So what I did in the Skrillex thing was I selected the main layer, the main text layer, so not the bit that we just filled with pattern, this is the brush layer. Get to select it, hold command or control for computer, for PC, and click on that little icon there over here. And then you want to go to select, modify, expand, and it's probably expanded by 2 or 1 depending on what image size you're working with. I'm just going to go 2. Does it that? Okay, so now we've got a little border around, a border selection around the main bit. What you want to do is go to the pattern layer. So, this is the pattern layer. And go to this little button down here, the mask, to create a layer mask. And what that's done is the complete opposite to what I want to do. So, see how that's all most of it's black and there's only a little bit of white bits. So what you want to do is Command I. And that's going to invert your mask, so then you've got a nice border around your main text, so you can still read everything, and the pattern is not the main focus of everything, so the different level. So then, okay, now basically that's what you're going to do for every different color on the person. So I'm just going to go ahead and do the gray. I might speed this up, I may not. Went the wrong way there. Okay. This one. Okay, then, okay. Brush. Make a new layer, so. Layer above that, go to our brush, then probably go to your eyedropper tool and actually make it the color that that gray is. So yeah, mine's already selected over here. Okay, so go to your brush, we'll hide the layer so we can see what we're doing, and we'll just do this. We got random things. About it for that now. To make another new layer and do a pattern fill. So remember again, right click, fill, go to pattern, okay. And then what we're going to do for this one to make it all the same color is we're going to have to command click on the layer, select it, and then swap these around. See, that's the gray, that's the rest of them, so swap that around, and shortcut to do is command backspace. So then it's done that same problem again, which it's going to do for every layer. So once again, click on command, select your main layer, go select, modify, expand by 2, then this time I'm going to go command I, so then it doesn't do that problem with the mask again. And then I'm going to go to the layer that we filled with the pattern and create a mask. And I don't know what I just did there. Anyway. May have stuffed up a little bit here. So that is the pattern. This one. Okay, pattern, mask, range, Okay, there you go. Now it's done that again. This image, it's not the best image in the world, but once we get this black and white, bring it out a little bit more. And new layer again, select color range, black, cancel just an old layer, color range, black. Okay, now we go to the brush, go to some black now, go to our layer, and hide our face again so we can see what we're doing. Put sexy everywhere. Sexy, here we go, whatever you want. Whatever fights about, I guess. You mean? Okay, now we can do a pattern fill. We can layer behind it and man click here that layer. Select modify, expand to enter, and then go to that one, our pattern fill, and create a we have to create a pattern fill first. Go back. Okay, now got that one. Gotta make a new layer, and we have to fill it with a pattern. So fill with pattern. Okay. And then select that. Then we have to do modify expand again. Okay. Then go to that should be below it. To this and create a mask. And invert it again. So command shift. Oh no, command I. And there we go. As I said, this picture isn't the best one to do in the world. It's very busy. In fact, I won't even... so you could, play with your opacities and stuff. That might help if something's busy like this one. Just gonna try and find the right layer. Because I'm retarded. This one, I'll probably put the opacity down a little bit. Just to bring out the rest. If you're wondering how I... Wait, I'll just fill this with a better looking color, because that's ugly as fuck. That's even uglier. What the hell? Yeah, there we go. Whatever. If you're wondering how I did the half, it's called halftone images, those little dots that were all over my image. I actually downloaded them from Adam Styles pack, his 2K pack I think it was. I think they're from, if you can't download his pack, I think they're on, you can probably find them on Media Militia, I think it's the same thing. They're basically just a whole bunch of patterns and shades that are all made out of dots. You can use it on vector art and stuff, there's some coloured ones like that, it's pretty cool. That's the one that I used on the bottom of the Skrillex one. Some really nice things. You make some really nice effects with it. I just placed them in and, played with some stuff. Put some color correction on. I'll just do that quickly for you. Okay, how long have we been going? Going for 19 minutes. Better wrap it up then. So if you liked it, please comment, like, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I just made myself a website that should be up soon. If anyone knows how to code a PSD straight into a working HTML, CSS, whatever website, and you'd be willing to do it for free or for cheap, you please contact me, and also please follow me on Behance. I'll put the link in description. It's got more of my professional work that I do in my diploma. It's got some website stuff, and I'll be putting up my packaging design soon, stuff like that. And it's jake.oxley, and also I need a 2D intro. If anyone would be able to do that for cheap or free because you love me, that'd be great. Anyways, see you later. Peace.